videos. It's been 1 month since your last video. Time for your mandatory stalker bot guide.
Yes, honey.
Opa! Well, boys, new pick just dropped. The Gunslinger adaptation for Shadow of Chernobyl received a new update, and it's huge. It adds and fixes several things. I'll leave the patch notes in the description. Let's get to the chase and move on to the install guide. First, the devs mentioned that you need to install VC Redist x64 for the mod to work. And for good measure, go ahead and update your DirectX Play as well, just in case. This is something that you only have to do once and never again. Now that you've got those frameworks installed, you want to download the Gunslinger archive from the link below. Once downloaded, go to your C drive and make a new folder. Call it whatever you want. Next, open your Gunslinger archive, preferably with 7-zip, but WinRAR works just fine. Go inside this folder, select everything and dump it inside the Gunslinger folder you made on the C drive. Alternatively, you can just extract the mod archive into the C drive and it would work just as well. Only thing left is to launch the game. Simply head over to bin x64, launch xrengine.exe. Now inside the game, open the console, type language ang and hit enter. The game is now in English. Now from here, you can either start playing right away or maybe get yourself some add-ons. Luckily, installing them is very easy. First, find the add-on that you want to use from the add-ons channel in the server. Once downloaded, create a new folder. Nomenclature doesn't matter, just name it something related to the add-on. Inside your folder, open the add-on archive and move the game data folder over to your add-on folder. Now copy the folder over to the add-ons folder. How many fucking times did I say folder? Folder? I don't even know her. Once copied, open gsgme.exe. You should find your add-on on the left-hand side of the window. Simply select it, then click the right arrow button to activate it. Depending on the add-on weight, there will be a green loading bar down here. Wait for it to finish, and your add-on is activated. Go inside the game to check the results. Some add-ons that I highly recommend are the Summer OGSR Texture Pack for a more vibrant zone, or alternatively, the Radiophobia Texture Pack for a more grim and gritty one. Vivid Weather or CGIM for an immersive weather, vanilla models updated for high fidelity and vanilla friendly NPC models, or you can use the HD models as an alternative. TS sounds for gun sounds from True Stalker, Stalker 2 HUD for, well, a Stalker 2 themed HUD. This one only affects the health, stamina, radiation and ammo textures. For the inventory, use either the EFP UI or better yet, Stalker 2 UI for the perfect match. Here's how my list looks like. That's all, fellas. Thank you for tuning in to my updated guide. I'll probably re-review the mod now that the update is out. Yeah, fuck you, Meeside, you'll have to wait. Anyway, I'll see you later.
So this is post-editing videos here. It's currently 12 a.m. and the devs have just dropped a new patch, hotfix, I should say. So you probably want to update your game first before doing anything. You can see me updating the game without removing my add-ons first. That's not recommended. I highly advise you that you disable your add-ons before updating the game in any way. But I launched it and my PC didn't explode, so I'm probably good. So yeah, that's it. I'll see you later.
Well, why don't you improvise scripts, Vityaz? This is the reason. I'm fucking autistic.